When we hear a sentence like Peter congratulated Mary, we typically infer that there must have been an occasion for him to do so. For instance, she may have won some competition. We argue that such occasions are presuppositions of verbs like congratulate. In three rating studies, we show that what we call occasion verbs pattern with well-established triggers of projective content. We also show that occasion verbs are interesting for another reason. Their presupposed content can be justified categorically. Occasion verbs include praise, reward, thank, punish, and criticize, among other. There is some overlap with Fillmore's judgment verbs, but occasion verbs haven't been much studied in theoretical semantics. However, they are well known in psycholinguistics as the agent-evocator subclass of implicit causality verbs. With regard to our study, these verbs display one very interesting property. In production studies, participants show a strong preference for providing a particular explanation about the object when continuing a sentence like Peter congratulated Mary. As we have shown in previous research, those explanations represent reasons for the agent's action, which is what the occasions are. We have earlier proposed that the preference for explanations comes about because the occasioning event is presupposed and participants follow the strategy of verifying presuppositions. The family of sentence tests seem to confirm this assumption. Thus, for instance, if someone asks, "Did Peter congratulate Mary?" they seem to presuppose that there was an occasion for Peter doing so. It's notable that participants provide those explanations after the trigger. In other words, they verify the presumed presupposition cataphorically. However, such verification should be heavily constrained according to standard theories. Thus, if we are on the right track with respect to occasion verbs, projective contents could be argued to be even more diverse than often assumed. Over three experiments, we provide evidence for these assumptions. First, that occasion presuppositions can be verified categorically. Second, that occasion verbs pattern with other presupposition triggers with regard to productivity in questions. And finally, we show that occasion verbs show symmetric filtering behavior where other triggers fail to do so. In all experiments, we compared occasion verbs to other expressions more standardly associated with projective content. Among them are personal pronouns, definite noun phrases, factive and aspectual verbs, in addition to clefts. Turning first to the issue of cataphoric verifiability, we asked participants to rate the acceptability of the following three conditions, which followed a short introductory sentence like "Mary and Peter are neighbors." First, there was an anaphoric condition, as in "It was his birthday yesterday. She congratulated him," where the presupposed content in blue precedes the trigger in red. Second, we had a cataphoric condition, in which the presupposed content follows the trigger. And finally, a neutral condition, testing how easily the presupposed content can be accommodated. These are the results from one sub-experiment comparing occasion verbs on the far left to seven other triggers. One takeaway is that the presuppositions of occasion verbs are not easily accommodated. See the blue bars. If we restrict our attention to the triggers that are less prone to accommodation, occasion verbs are the only triggers to be equally acceptable in anaphoric and cataphoric conditions. See the red and green bars. To show that occasion verbs do indeed pattern with other triggers of projective content, we applied the paradigm from Tornhaus and colleagues 2018. They used simple dialogue settings for which participants provided ratings of projectivity as speaker commitment and of at-issueness. Participants were asked to imagine that they're overhearing a conversation where someone asks, "Did Peter congratulate Mary?" Participants' task was to assess how certain the speaker would be that there was an occasion upon which Peter congratulated Mary. High ratings indicate that the presupposition projects. At-issueness was assessed by asking whether the speaker is asking about the occasion itself. Here we expect low ratings if we're dealing with presupposed content. Consequently, productivity and at-issueness are assumed to be negatively correlated. The results show that occasion verbs, marked in red, are well within the middle field of all triggers as confirmed by clustering analysis. Moreover, we replicated the results of Tornhaus and colleagues for well-established triggers. Without going into details, we would also like to mention that we have since found these results to generalize to all other family of sentence contexts. Finally, we investigated filtering in the antecedent of conditionals. Consider the example in A with the aspectual trigger stop. If Mary used to do yoga and she stopped doing yoga, Matthew will interview her. Here, filtering should occur since the presupposed content precedes the trigger. However, a left-right asymmetry is assumed. For the reversed order, as in B, the presupposition should project. In a recent paper, Mandelkern and colleagues provided experimental evidence for such asymmetry for triggers like stop or be aware that. We predicted occasion verbs to pattern differently. We used the paradigm in Thornhauser and et al. Again, comparing occasion verbs to the triggers used by Mandelkern et al. Here we show productivity ratings for the antecedents of conditionals where the trigger occurs on its own, to the far left, when it's preceding the presupposed content, or when it follows it. For well-established triggers, see the red bars, we were able to replicate the findings by Mandelkern et al. We get projection unless the presupposed content occurs to the left of the trigger. However, we also found that occasion verbs, see the green bars, are different. The presupposition is filtered out both right to left and left to right. Why should occasion verbs behave this way? We believe it could be related to the informativity of presuppositions. Occasion presuppositions are highly uninformative. Peter could congratulate Mary on basically anything. Being abstract, it demands for further clarification, much as an unanswered question under discussion. This could make subsequent verification more acceptable. Thank you very much for your attention.